मॉर्निंग सिक्स क्लास आज हम डीजी क्लास करेंगे चैप्टर नंबर फर्स्ट का वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम फूड वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम ओके बेटा फूड कहाँ कहाँ से मिलता है फूड फ्रॉम वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम आज हम इसे डीजी क्लास में देखेंगे ओके बेटा बड़े ध्यान से इसे देखना आप
Every day we eat different kinds of food. Let us learn more about the different types of food and where they come from. James goes to a restaurant and checks the menu for Indian and Chinese cuisine. He reads the ingredients for dosa and fried rice. He is surprised to see that although the two dishes are so different from each other and they come from different cuisines, they both have rice as a main ingredient. Similarly, wheat is used to make a variety of food items such as pasta, bread, cake, biscuits, and pies. Milk is used to make food such as cheese, cottage cheese, curd cheese and butter. We saw that most ingredients can be used to make various types of food items. But where do we obtain these ingredients? All food that we eat mainly comes from two sources, plants and animals. We will look at both these sources in detail. Choose a food ingredient and make a list of the different food items that can be made from that ingredient. Discuss your list in class. James has ordered a yummy salad. What is there in the salad? There is carrot, celery, lettuce, tomato, broccoli, and corn. Which parts of plants do these ingredients come from? Carrot is a root. Celery, a stem. Lettuce is a leaf. Tomato is a fruit. Broccoli is a flower. And corn is a seed. We use various parts of plants as food. Let us look at the examples of some edible plant parts. Carrot, beetroot, parsnip, radish, turnip, and sweet potato are all examples of edible roots. Edible stems include sugarcane, celery, and asparagus. We also eat many other green stems, including potato, onion, garlic, and ginger. Delicious leaves of spinach, cabbage, lettuce, parsley, and coriander liven up our food. We eat flowers of many plants, such as broccoli, cauliflower, banana, and in some places, pumpkin.
Juicy fruits such as mangoes, kiwi fruit, apples, peaches, oranges, and melons are familiar to most of us.
Vegetables such as tomato, peas, cucumber, and capsicum are actually fruits. Various seeds are edible and they can be divided into groups, including cereals, pulses, and spices.
Green yam, known to us as the moon bean, is a popular pulse in India. Look at this image. These are moon beans too. But these look different from the moon beans that we saw earlier. Why is it so? These are sprouted moon beans. Sprouts of the herbal seeds are allowed to germinate. Sprouted seeds can be eaten raw or can be cooked to make a delicious snack.
Though plants form a major part of our food, we should not eat unknown plants, as they could be poisonous and harmful to our health. James has ordered a chicken sandwich with fried eggs for lunch. For dessert, he asks for a delicious combo of ice cream and honey. Which food ingredients are not from plants? Food ingredients are not from plants. The answer is chicken, eggs, ice cream, and honey. They are all animal products, or made chiefly from animal products. Food from animals includes meat, eggs, honey, and milk. Humans eat the meat of animals such as cattle, pigs, lambs, goats, chicken, fish, prawns, etc. Eggs are obtained for hens, ducks, and geese. Honey is the sweet liquid that honeybees make from the nectar of flowers. People either collect honey from beehives or rear bees in an apiary for honey production. This is called beekeeping or apiculture. Animals such as cows, buffaloes, and goats provide us with milk. In deserts, people consume camel milk, and people in the Arctic region use milk from the reindeer. Milk is also used to make many products such as cottage cheese, curd cheese, yogurt, butter, and ice cream. Do you know what these products are called? Average cow produces around 200,000 glasses of milk in her lifetime. Average cow produces around 200,000 glasses of milk in her lifetime. these animals? Can you categorize them on the basis of their food? Based on the foods they eat, animals are classified into three groups. These are herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Do these animals differ only in their eating habits, or are there any other differences? Let's find out. Serve them food only from plant sources. Cow, deer, horse, elephant, rabbit, giraffe, butterfly, and honeybee are examples of herbivores. They consume only plants or plant products. Where does the word herbivore come from? Herbie is from the Latin word herba, meaning plant, and vore, from Latin vorare, to eat, so it means eater. These animals have some characteristics that help them with their diet. Animals such as the cow, buffalo, and horse have broad and blunt teeth to pull and ground leaves and other plant parts. Plants such as grass are difficult to digest, so some herbivores, including the camel, giraffe, sheep, goat and cow have developed a mechanism for bringing the swallowed food from the stomach back to the mouth to chew. While some herbivores have to chew their food, others do not have to worry about it at all. Animals such as the hummingbird, butterfly, and honeybee have straw-like mouthparts that they use to suck nectar. Where the word carnivore comes from. Yes, carne is from the Latin word carnis, meaning meat, and vore from Latin vorare, to eat, meaning eater, as before. Tiger, lion, eagle, frog and shark are all carnivores. Like herbivores, carnivorous animals have some special characteristics that suit their diet. Can you work out what they might be? Many carnivores, such as the lion, tiger, and wolf, have sharp, pointed teeth that help them to tear the flesh and separate it from the bones. In addition, they have sharp claws to catch and kill their prey. Carnivorous birds such as the hawk, eagle, and owl have sharp and curved beaks that help them to tear the flesh of their prey. Flesh-eating fish such as shark and piranha possess many sharp teeth that they use to rip the flesh of their prey. Chameleons and frogs catch insects using their long and sticky tongues. Vultures are also carnivores, but they are classified into a separate group called scavengers, because they never hunt, but rather eat the remains of animals that have been hunted by other carnivores or that have died naturally or accidentally. You can be sure they love to eat, because sometimes they eat so much that they become too heavy to fly. Have you ever seen a chicken eating? Its favorite foods are seeds and worms. That means it eats foods from both plant and animal sources, and it is called an omnivore. Omni is from the Latin word omnis, meaning all. So, omnivores are animals that eat all sorts of food. Can you give examples of other omelets? The examples of omelets are the chimpanzee, the monkey, the bear, the crow, the raccoon, and humans. Omnivores have teeth that are well suited to eat both plant and animal foods. Sharp teeth help them to bite and tear food, while flat teeth grind the food into small pieces. Some omnivores, such as the North American raccoon and opossum, can eat almost anything they find. They dig into dustbins and gardens to find leftover food. Favorite foods are seeds and worms. That means it eats foods from both plant and animal sources, and it is called an omnivore. Omni is from the Latin word omnis, meaning all. So, omnivores are animals that eat all sorts of food. Can you give examples of other omnivores? The examples of omnivores are the chimpanzee, the monkey, the bear, the crow, the raccoon, and humans. Omnivores have teeth that are well suited to eat both plant and animal foods. Sharp teeth help them to bite and tear food, while flat teeth grind the food into small pieces. Some omnivores, such as the North American raccoon and opossum, can eat almost anything they find. They dig into dustbins and gardens to find leftover food. Have you ever seen a chicken eating? Its favorite foods are seeds and worms. That means it eats foods from both plant and animal sources, and it is called an omnivore. Omni is from the Latin word omnis, meaning all. So, omnivores are animals that eat all sorts of food. Can you give examples of other omnivores? The examples of omnivores are the chimpanzee, the monkey, the bear, the crow, the raccoon, and humans. Omnivores have teeth that are well suited to eat both plant and animal foods. Sharp teeth help them to bite and tear food, while flat teeth grind the food into small pieces. Some omnivores, such as the North American raccoon and opossum, can eat almost anything they find. They dig into dustbins and gardens to find leftover food. Have you ever seen a chicken eating? Its favorite foods are seeds and worms. That means it eats foods from both plant and animal sources, and it is called an omnivore. Omni is from the Latin word omnis, meaning all. So, omnivores are animals that eat all sorts of food. Can you give examples of other omnivores? The examples of omnivores are the chimpanzee, the monkey, the bear, the crow, the raccoon, and humans. Omnivores have teeth that are well suited to eat both plant and animal foods. Sharp teeth help them to bite and tear food, while flat teeth grind the food into small pieces. Some omnivores, such as the North American raccoon and opossum, can eat almost anything they find. They dig into dustbins and gardens to find leftover food. Sort the animals into three groups on the basis of their eating habits. Click the animal and then click the correct column.
बेटा आपने देखा आज डीजी क्लासेस फ्रॉम वेयर वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम फूड फ्रॉम वेयर डज इट कम्स फ्रॉम हमने डीजी क्लास में देखा अब इसकी रिवीजन अच्छे से करना ओके बेटा इसको बड़े अच्छे से देखना अभी ओके